Hey guys, welcome at Away From Keyboard, and today we're going to take a look at Is the Mega Man X Legacy Collection Worth Playing? Mega Man X Legacy Collection has hit the shelves, but only in Europe as a digital download.
In America, it's different. You got the Mega Man Legacy Collection 1 and 2 on a normal disc. Yeah, in Europe, it's just a digital download. You can download it in the PlayStation Store, Xbox Store,
Switch.
And Switch, it's also a disc.
It's a physical edition, the small one.
Yeah.
Mega Man X, also known as Rockman X or Rakumanu X, Rakumanu X, in Japan, is based on the original series called Mega Man, which was first released on the NES. It was basically a run and gun game, so a side scroller with some puzzle elements to it, but basically it was just a very hard game.
Yeah, the first release of Mega Man X was in 1993. That was in Japan. The release for North America was in 1994 and was released on the Super NES and the Super Famicom.
Apart from the game, the disc also contains some other features.
Yeah, the disc got some extras what we've never seen in the games or anything. It includes a gallery with illustrations, music, videos. You also got a video animation called The Day of Sigma. This animation will unlock when you clear the game. The rest of the extras are an high res option. This option gives you kind of filter over the game, so it looks a little bit nicer. Also, there's the most fun thing. The best feature they added is a new feature called the X Challenge. This is a challenge-based minigame where the player can kick ass with two bosses. Yeah, we've never seen something like this in Mega Man before. So it will give the more experienced players some fun thing to do.
Ah, cool. Besides the extras, it also contains 8 Mega Man X games. Starting from X1 to X8.
Yeah.
Apart from all the features and all the extra stuff you get, Mega Man X, what is it all about? We know it is based on the NES Mega Man games, but
yeah,
where do we start?
Mega Man X is like his predecessor, Mega Man. Mm-hmm. It plays similar. The only thing different about this is that they added some few features like sliding. You've got to slide in Mega Man, yeah. But the controlling is better and everything. Also, you got a wall climbing. You can stick against the wall.
Kind of like Smash, if you jump against the wall with Lucario.
You can jump again.
Oh, like a wall jump.
You can slide against the wall, okay. And then you can jump again. Also, you got a dash jump at the same time. So you can jump and dash to the front. So you can be quicker in the game. You can even play some levels without using the gun.
Oh, that's amazing.
With a jump dash. All the time you can
except
jump
for the
over
bosses,
everything.
Of course.
Yeah, of course you need to fight them with your gun, but it makes it a little bit easier than his predecessor.
Yeah, so you can kind of say that Mega Man X is Mega Man on steroids. Faster,
yeah.
Better,
yeah.
More awesome. Yeah, but besides the abilities, it still plays out like the old Mega Man game. So you've got a few bosses you've got to defeat. Every level has its own kind of setting.
Yeah.
And that setting suits the boss, and the boss has some kind of ability you can take over after defeating him.
Yep. In X there is also another difference. This difference is that you can find capsules in the levels. Mm-hmm. They are a little bit hidden. Some capsules you can find easily, but some are hard to get to. In these capsules you can upgrade your character.
Oh, cool.
So you can get a helmet, boots, chest plates, your gun, your blaster gun can upgrade. This gives the ability to defeat monsters easier.
And you keep those parts throughout the game.
Yeah.
So it's kind of like they've added a little RPG feature to the game in which you can upgrade your character.
You can collect stuff.
Yeah.
Even later in the game, you get more kinds of upgrades and everything. And you can even build a custom armor set and everything with other powers.
Yeah. Also in X1 there was a new character introduced. It wasn't playable yet, but it was an awesome character and I think everybody wanted to play him, but you never got to play him in this game.
He was called
Zero.
He was leader of the Maverick Hunters, and in 3 they just put him in the game and you could play him.
Yeah, that's awesome.
I think everybody who played the game was like, what the fuck's happening? What? The cool feature about this player was he had a beam saber and you could fight with it and everything, but you also got a gun.
Yeah, so it was close range, melee, slash, long range.
And then X4, X5, they took the gun out and just gave him that beam saber and just slash away through the levels. Awesome.
But the main part was that X and X2 were released on the Super NES.
Yeah.
And later on they were released on the PlayStation and the PlayStation 2.
Yeah.
So they could do more, they could add more in the game. And it was hard to create this character on the Super NES because there wasn't enough space on the cartridge and they couldn't do everything like they wanted to.
No, that's what you see. You got some new features like ducking.
Mm-hmm.
That was only put in at X4, X5 and the later games.
Yeah.
You could duck in the game. And we've never seen that before in the other X games. So they just put on features and features and features.
Yeah.
Made it a little bit better and everything. You didn't have that on the Super NES.
No, that's right.
X6, they put in a rescue system. You need to save other Reploids.
Yeah.
You just go through the game, you just find them on various spaces and you just need to save them. Then we got X6. This character is called Axel. This character is next generation Reploid.
They are basically robots who are like humans.
Yeah.
So they can grow, they can learn, they can talk, they can think for themselves.
And they can make decisions and grow with them.
Yeah.
Well, Axel is the next generation, so they gave him 2 guns. He can mimic the internal and external characteristics of everything he encounters. So that's, he can get the ice gun, the things that X can do.
Mm-hmm.
He can do that also, but it's less, it does less damage than X does.
So it doesn't make X obsolete, because that was what I afraid
yeah.
of. What I was afraid of, because X already is the less popular of the two. And then you put in another character, and if he's even better than X, then why would you ever play as X?
Yeah, that's why. Then we got 8, and 8 brought a little feature, and that is that you can double attack. And this means you can attack with 2 characters at a time.
Okay, so we get to the conclusion. Is Mega Man X the Legacy Collection really worth playing today?
For me, it's worth playing. You get so much extra features for the hardcore players, for the noobs under us. Yeah, it's worth playing. It gives you a lot of hours to play through the game, to do challenge mode and everything, to see all the videos, all the stories. So yeah, I say it's worth playing.
if you are a newcomer to the X series, because like me, I've only played the NES games, which game would you recommend to me?
I would recommend X4. It's the most easy one to play through, and you will learn the characters, how you slide, everything you can do in 3, X2, X1, you can do over there. So you get 0, you get X, you get all the features.
Alright guys, now we would like to know from you, which Mega Man game is your favorite game? Let us know in the comments below. Don't say Mega Man 64 because we will come and hunt you down. And also we would like to know from you guys what game we should do next in our Worth Playing series. Let us know down below. And we hope to see you next time on Away From Keyboard.
Later guys.